Michael Camden Hughes on piano. We're going to play a little improv game right now, and I'd like to introduce your contestants. First, we've got Aaron for the last time, No Means No, Baldessari. And Jeremy, hey, chicks dig body odor, Hugus. Alright, now as we get started, I need you guys to pick a style of music for our contestants.
Country.
What was that? Hoedown? Hoedown? I heard hoedown. Alright. Relax. Alright, now we need a theme. Anybody?
Jesus.
Fairy tale!
Jesus. Fairy tale. I like fairy tales. So, gentlemen, we are performing a hoedown with the theme fairy tale.
Too bad, you could put us up for sale. Your costumes look pretty neat. I saw a guy in woman's clothes. If you don't have fun here, you could always sit back and clean out jam from your toes.
We've got lots of good shows tonight that will sure to entertain. We got shows and things that I'm sure will blow your brain. Be sure as you watch the show to keep in mind that the hosts you see before you look much better from behind.
Tonight, it's in Snow White or Three Little Pigs.
Skinny, fat, young, and old people wearing makeup, ribbons, and wigs.
Everybody cool is here tonight, every Harry, Dick, and Tom.
They seem to be having fun so far, especially your mom. We hope you don't throw vegetables. We hope you don't throw eggs. So if you do, we'll find you. Sit back and relax and watch the show with me. A rip-roaring fairy tale with time for Fresheree.
I think we're gonna pretend to host a Fresheree talent show.
I think so too.
Let's go, Rob.
It's the sophomore class council. So enjoy.
Glad to make it tonight.
Glad you can all make it. What a lovely young.
No sign of the EEC, Gretel.
What's the EEC?
The Entertainment Evaluation Committee, headed up by the dreadful Tim Milburn.
You two didn't think you'd get away that easy, or did you?
Quick, Gretel, go get the fairy tale posse!
Will the real Tim Milburn please stand up? I repeat, will the real Tim Milburn please stand up? Please stand up.
What? Hello. All right, Kyle, I'm here. And I brought my crew, the EEC. All right, look. All right. Section 1, subsection A, calls for a battle. A rap battle.
Yeah. There's really no else to say it. I can't explain it.
I think the Tim's gone crazy.
A little helper. SBA won't save me.
I think the Tim's gone crazy.
Nothing else we can say. Not even Fresheree.
I think the Tim's gone crazy.
All right, check this out. Let's get down to business. I ain't got no time to play around. What is this? Fresheree's in town. I'm gonna shut the show down. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Let's get down to business. I ain't got no time to play around. What is this? I'm gonna shut. Fresheree's in town. I'm gonna shut the show down. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Boo.
Yeah. All right. You ain't got nothing, old man Milburn. So sometimes the EEC just seems everybody wants to discuss me. So this must mean I'm interesting. This just me, I'm just Rob T. Though I'm not the first king of controversy, I am the best thing since Phineas Prezi. Hey, here's a concept that works. 20 million other fresh acts emerge. But no matter how many skips in the sea, feel so empty without Fresheree. So the EEC won't let me be, or let me be me, or let me see. They try to shut me down in Fresheree. Feel so empty without me.
Oh man, who did you get that? You know, man, oh, that was off the chain, man.
Word.
Oh yeah, man, they got a club in that business. You know what I'm saying? They got the hippity hop and all that other stuff.
Freedom.
Yeah, man, that's what I love that. You know what I'm saying? Hey, we got.
Yeah.
What's up with this man? How you doing, my man? Come on, man, get up here. Come on, man. What up, buddy?
Yeah, bro.
You guys aren't black.
Oh, come on, this is a boy headed. Come on, just maintain it. Come on, man.
That's ridiculous.
Oh, what's up with that?
What you talking?
They say I'm not black.
You guys are white. That's ridiculous.
Listen,
you guys are so white.
Oh, my God, look at that. That's my hot dog timer going on.
What the?
Come on, look at my hot dog. You know what I'm saying? Y'all all kinds of crazy hot dogs. What do you think of that, Bobby? Some hot dogs or what?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, hot dogs. Oh, man, it's hot.
Oh, they gonna burn.
Oh, they gonna burn. Woo!
Anybody want some hot dog? Yeah! You gotta stand up. Oh, we gotta kick her.
Well, that was fun.
You know what you're asking? I thought we were black. I thought we were black too.
I guess we just can't pull it, man.
Maybe he was right. I'm pretty white, man.
You're really white. Yeah.
In fact, you know who else is white?
No.
Sam Fleischman?
Yes.
Guess who else is white?
Very white. Tim McGraw.
It's true. So, rumor has it that back in freshman year, Crystal Back has Sam Fleischman do an act of Fresheree. You're not going to believe this. He's here tonight. Apparently, he's going to make good on his promise. We're going to do a little skit for Fresheree. We got a little song we thought might introduce him. It's more of a...
It's like a cowboy song.
It's more of a white song.
Round him up! Here he is, Sam
Faith Hill, where you at?
Hey,
get some gasoline. And I drove out to Pennsylvania. When I saw her for the first time, she was staring at me with a smile. A love started right then and there. Oh, the sailor sky made a perfect sunset.
Successful pressure react. And the first thing that's very important is you show up.
Be there.
If you're not there for your act, it ain't gonna happen.
Dead in the water.
Absolutely right. Very important. Number two, we suggest you have some sort of an idea. A good idea, probably.
In your brain.
Maybe. And
Tell it to the audience.
Yeah, very good. The very third, very important, we want to get this in. Use some sort of word. Words.
From your mouth.
You can say
them out loud.
Right. That's the thing. What your idea is. To the audience. Very important. Because you can show up and have an idea, but if you can't actually use some words with your mouth to
convey.
That's a good word.
Yeah,
nothing says I care.
Like words.
Very good. Very true. And so thank you for joining us this evening. And those were the three things that we wanted to talk to you about tonight. And amen. Now, my goodness, look at there. Hot diggity dog. Order some more hot dogs. We want hot dogs.
Thank you. your hand there, Father?
Yeah. I'll go ahead and feel your lower, man. What do you think?
Oh, thanks, sir.
What do you think of that?
Not bad, man.
Don't they play any time today, then,
huh? Pete, what are you doing? I'm trying to...
What do they look like? No, no, I don't make a gimmick for crying out loud.
Music, huh?
Oh, you haven't ever seen stunt before, huh? Why did I ask? Yeah, well, I put stunt on. We go out making things, making crazy noise, you know? That's what I am, you know? See? You know, I'm stuck for crying out loud.
You're making a noise.
Someone's never been to Fresheree, huh?
You're trying to concentrate.
Hey, well, then concentrate then, why don't you?
Rappy nuts.
Oh, you think you're a tough guy, huh? You want to know, huh?
nicknames. I don't really do any cool stuff like these guys. Anyway, hey, Palantir!
What's that smell? Can you smell it? Can you see it? Can you hear it? What time is it?
It is time to break me!
For Dismont!
The Exorcist. He's gonna show us his spirit-filled speed by racing for grace and his spirit-filled power by breaking boards for the Lord.
Do it, do it.
Exorcist, do it. Exorcise that demon.
Yeah!
train, destination, God. That a boy, that a boy. Okay. He's got that look in his eye. Michelle's got that look in his eye. Michelle, he's gonna break bricks. He does it with, he beats the devil with shock and awe. Here we go, Michelle. Guitar guy who plays behind me. Get him out here. Come here. Just stand here. Play a little music behind the altar call. Okay. What you see tonight is real. These are real people. And those were real bricks. That is real power. Do you want that power? Do you want it?
No.
I'm not done with the altar call yet.
No.
It's just a little premature. It's okay. I'm not done yet. That's all. Can you just sit back there, all right? Come up in a minute. Seriously. As I was saying, you can have this power. You can break bricks. You can tear phone books. You can break golf clubs, and you can run fast. You know, because maybe you're missing that right now. Maybe you can't break things. Maybe you can't even rip a scam book in half. You need the Lord. You need the Lord.
Hey, what is this?
Never in my life. Never in my life have I seen a backup strummer during the altar call just take center stage. What are you doing? Do you have a power team nickname? You do? Good, good. Not anymore. Do you guys smell that? Can you see it? Can you hear it? What is it time for? It's duct tape time!
Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah! Duct tape! Do it!
This is the last thing the power team does every night. This is you. Duct tape our hands together, and we break it apart as a team. It's hardly ever done by human men. We're gonna give it a shot. I'm a little nervous, I'm not gonna lie. And so we're gonna get it. You're gonna come on.
Yeah.
Might need to grab his hand.
That's the ticket, Steve.
Come on, you dick boy.
That's
one. Okay. You guys ready? Let's go. Let's do it for the Lord!
Yeah!
Yes, I do!
be the Holy Spirit?
How about you do your power, Kingston?
What is that?
It's the liberal winter timer, stud.
Woo!
Oh yeah, turn him on, folks. He's gonna do it. He's gonna do it. Come on, Baldy. Come on, turn him on, folks. Woo!
Okay, Jeremy Hoops can do something. He's gonna open a new package of hot dogs!
Gentlemen, I'm Joy Kaplan, and today I'll be doing a humorous monologue. In this monologue, Fran is confiding in her best friend over her boyfriend's eating habits. Thank you. Mary, eating with Dan is like eating with a wolf. Maybe a wolf pack. You've never seen anybody eat like this in your entire life. We go out, and he orders everything. I'm talking everything. Last night, after the movies, we went to Jimmy's for a bite. Just a bite. A snack, okay? But no, with Dan, it's never a snack. It's always garbage time. We get into the restaurant. We have a seat. I order a large Pepsi because that's all I'm in the mood for. But when the guy asks what Dan wants, he can't tell him because he's too busy going over the menu like it's a book he has to memorize for a test or something. Finally, after mulling over the menu for 5 minutes, he rattles off his order. Okay, let's see. A milkshake, an order of onion rings, a large order of fries, a double cheeseburger with 3 kinds of cheeses, and to top it off, a piece of pecan pie a la mode. The waiter had a hard time getting it all down because the poor guy didn't even know shorthand. Mary, it was so embarrassing. Having your date turn into a total pig right before your eyes is not a pleasant sight. So anyway, here comes the food. They deliver it on a forklift. Here are the Himalayas and he's ready to fly. Now Dan just doesn't eat. He devours. He digs into the pile of goat with both hands. Forget about forks. And so he can get more milkshake, he uses 4 straws. Yeah, it was like washing jaws. No, but it gets better. Get this. He persists on pouring globs and globs of ketchup all over his fries till it looks like they're bleeding to death. My goodness. It's like watching an episode of ER. Anyway, he eats his burger and his pie right along with everything else. So you got pecan pie a la mode in your face. Yeah, honey, thanks so much for a kiss, huh? So anyway, he eats everything off of his plate. He wipes it down with a piece of leftover hamburger bun. We pick up the receipt. We're ready to go home. And the next thing I hear out of Dan's mouth, so, hey, honey, you want to go to Taco Bell and get a taco?
Yeah.
Can you believe that? Honey, Mary, I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't think I can take this anymore. You do not understand what I'm going through with Dan. I mean, he's driving me nuts. I don't Too bad he's so darn buff. Thank you.
Hey, Baldy.
Hey, Ugas.
I like going to NNU. It's pretty fun. What are you doing?
I don't know. I got a microphone.
Cool. Let's get hot dogs. What's the deal with everyone in our school feeling the need to do the beatbox? It's like a crazy kid. Weird. Hey, come over to my place and we'll, you know, play some bowl games.
Everybody's there, mom is doing it.
Right. It's so crazy. I'm from Wyoming.
Yeah.
What about cowboys beatbox like?
Beatboxing, like.
Clearly, probably not as good as.
We'll see what they have.
We'll see what they
have. Yeah. People who can bring it on.
Bring it on. Let's give it up for some better beatboxers than us.
We gotta do the
check.
Alright, we gotta
tune it up real quick.
I'm gonna change. Up here, I want to put a little bit up here. Okay, I think a little bit lower. Okay, we're gonna try.
Don't get on that G, we wanna hit the G, we're on the G, we need a little bit of the G. Okay, we got it.
Alright, okay.
Alright, let's try. Okay, we're trying.
Yeah, we did a little, that was lame. Yeah! Alright, so how many of y'all have seen movies like
Eight Mile.
Probably never got there. Maybe any hip hop, any booty grinding music video. You know, you've all seen
them. Like
okay, I know everybody can do this. So, I don't know if you guys got room to stand up or if you want to sit down. These guys are going to stand up right here.
They're
going to stand up. So we're going to throw up a little bit of this. We're going to get some crowd participation. You ready?
So pick it out. So everybody in the Fresheree, put your hands in the sky and follow me. Everybody in the Fresheree, put your hands in the sky and follow me. In the
tomorrow morning. Brooks Wheatley could grow this much better here today, but I can't. So, I would say November, I'm supposed to make that. And second thing I wanted to say is, well, actually I have two more. I already said that. We have Force Fist coming out. He's not in your program, but he's going to do a little stunt for us. And then the last thing I was supposed to ask, is there anyone from Bloodbath here tonight?
Yeah!
Was vacuuming his house, trying to get rid of every bit of dirt that there was. In his obsession with trying to get rid of every single speck of dirt, he accidentally sucked up the household cat's and then he said to himself, "Silk, we need to get this cat out of here. Oh, I need some help," he said. "I need some help right quick." So he called his friend, "Fred, I need your help. Come down here quick. Fred, help me out here. We need to get this cat out of this tube." And in the process of getting the cat out of the tube, he learned how to play the didgeridoo. Here's how the story goes. First, he tried to stretch the cat out of the tube. But to no avail, the cat was still in the tube. "All right, Fred, we have two more tricks. Let's try swinging it around. The centrifugal force will get the cat out. We need to get him out of there. All right, here we go." One more time, I think he's still in there. No, he's still in there, mate. We need one more. Yes, we'll spank him out. We'll spank the cat out of the tube. Well, I think he's in there for good, but I've learned a few new tricks. Thanks, Fred. Take care of the thing and fix it, I don't know. But in the process, he went to his house and said, "You know what? There's something at my house that looks just like a didgeridoo. I mean, just like a vacuum cleaner, so just like it. It's a PVC pipe." And he's like, "Oh, this looks interesting." So he sits down and he's like, "Oh, I'll start playing with this. See what happens." I mean, that's incredible. And so he lost his obsessive compulsive disorder, and he went out into the forest, into the bush, and what he found was a stick. Oh, there we go. He found a stick that was in a termite's nest, and he's like, "Oh, there's nasty little ants all over this stick." He's like, "Get those ants out of there. I want my didgeridoo." So he sat down that day, had a few ants next. Sat down, composed a little ditty. Yeah. think the cat's still in there.
You have time all in here, but you all know that. You little friends, don't you? What's on second? I I know his answer.
You're the manager?
Yes.
And you're going to be the coach too?
Yes.
And you don't know the fellow's name?
Well, I should.
Well, then who's on first?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
Who?
The guy in first.
Who?
The guy playing first base.
Who?
The guy in first base.
Who is on first?
What are you asking me for? I'm asking you.
I'm not asking you. I'm telling you.
You ain't telling me nothing. I'm asking you who's on first.
That's the man's name?
That's whose name?
Yes.
Look, take the first baseman.
Yes.
And tell the fellow's name on first base.
Who?
The guy playing first base.
Who?
The guy on first base.
Who?
The guy playing first base.
Who is on first?
What are you asking me for? That's who?
Yes.
All right.
Okay.
You have a first baseman.
Yes.
Then tell me the fellow's name on first base.
Who?
You pay him off every month, right?
Right.
And so when you pay the first baseman, who gets the money?
Every dollar of it.
Yeah. You just don't pay the money without anybody getting the money, right?
Right.
Does he give you a receipt?
Yes.
How does he send the receipt?
Who?
The guy you give the money to.
Who?
The guy you give the paper to.
Who?
The guy who gets the paper.
That's how he signs it.
That's how who signed it.
Yes.
How does his name look to you?
Who?
The guy you give the paper.
Who?
How does his name look to you?
That's how he signed it.
Who signed it?
Yes.
But he gets the paper. How does his name look to you?
Who?
To you.
Who?
To you.
Who?
To you. Okay, forget it. I'm trying to figure out what the guy did on first base.
What's on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
Who's on first?
How did he get on third base?
Well, you mentioned his name.
If I mentioned his name, then who did I say is playing third?
Who's on first?
Wait, one base at a time.
Well, don't change the players.
I ain't changing nobody.
I'm getting excited.
I'm not getting excited.
Babies, come on.
I'm trying to figure out what the guy's name on first base.
What's on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
That's what I'm asking you. Well,
don't change the players around.
What's the guy's name on first base?
What's on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
Third.
There we go again. Back to third base. All right. Just stay on third base and don't go off of it.
All right. I'm on third. What do you want to know?
Now, who's on first base? Who's playing third base?
Why do you insist on putting who on third base?
What am I putting on third?
What's on second?
Who's on second?
Who's on first?
I don't know.
Third base.
Do you have an outfielder's name?
Well, of course we do.
Left outfielder's name.
Why?
I just thought I'd ask you.
I just thought I'd tell you.
Then please tell me who's playing left field.
Who's on first?
I'm asking you who's on first. Left outfielder's name.
Why?
Because!
Well, now he's center field. Of course we do. Wouldn't this be a fine team without a pitcher?
Pitcher's name.
Tomorrow.
What time?
What time what?
What time tomorrow are you going to tell me who's pitching?
Listen, who is
I'll break your arm off and say who's on first. I just want to know what's the pitcher's name.
What's on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
Today.
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 So today's catching and tomorrow's pitching?
Now you got it.
Now I've got it. How it happens a couple of days on the team. You know, I'm a pretty good catcher myself.
Oh, so they tell me.
So let's have a little scenario.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Okay, let's say tomorrow I'm pitching and I'm catching. And a big heavy hitter gets up. Now let's say that when tomorrow pitches the ball, the guy bunts it, and he takes off the first. So me, being a good catcher, I would throw the guy out at first, right?
Right.
So I would throw it to the first baseman, so I'd pick up the ball, and I would throw it to who?
Now that's the first thing you said right.
I don't even know what I'm talking about.
Look, that's all you have to do.
Is throw the ball to first base.
Yes.
So who's got it?
Naturally.
If I throw the ball to first base, someone on first base has got to have it. Now, who's got it?
Naturally.
Naturally? naturally. So I pick up the ball and I throw it to naturally. He picks up the ball.
No, you pick up the ball and you throw it to who?
Naturally.
That's different.
That's what I'm saying.
You're not saying it.
I pick up the ball and I throw it to who?
Naturally.
Now you ask me.
You throw it to who?
Naturally.
Naturally.
Naturally. Stand here! I pick up the ball and I throw it to first base. Whoever it is drops the ball and the guy takes off the second. So the guy in first base throws it to what? What throws it to? I don't know. I don't know. Throws it back to tomorrow. Triple play.
Could be.
And then let's say another guy gets up and hits a long fly ball to become. Why? I don't know. He's on third, and I don't give a darn.
Wait, what was that?
I said I don't give a darn.
Well, he's our shortstop.
My name is Norm, and today I'm going to be on the Norm. I'd like to introduce a guest for you today. This is very special for me to do this. Jerry, come on, tell us a little bit about yourself, Jerry.
It's great to be here, Norm. Well, I have been gifted with some preconceived notions like what you call extrasensory perceptibility.
Wow.
Yes.
Extrasensory perceptibility.
That means I can take thoughts out of the air and it helps you. It's like reading minds. But it's really, I used it more to help people.
Right, naturally. Well, I tell you what, you folks are in for a great treat this evening. Because it just so happens that Jerry is going to do a little demonstration for us.
Well, I'd love to.
Thanks so much. Pleasure to have you with us.
Okay. Before I begin, I think it's important that you realize the importance of remembering the details of our session here tonight, especially those things that don't seem to make sense at first. Okay, I'm ready to begin.
Thank you.
I'm walking this direction over here. I'm walking over here, this direction. Someone over here knows somebody with a J. Your name starts with a J. Anybody with a J connection? A J or an R? Someone with a J or an R. Someone who knows somebody who knows somebody who has a J or an R in their name or outside of their name. I'm getting a man. He's trying to reach somebody. Someone has lost a man. His name begins with a G. His name begins with a G or an S or a P, a Q, a T, or a B. No, okay, maybe might have been a woman. A woman who owned an animal or saw an animal in the wild or perhaps a zoo setting. Okay, somebody, a woman with a G, Z, P, Q, or S. Okay, we have an S. I'm getting Sophia. Sophia, no? Well, I'm getting Sophia. You calling me a liar? Okay. Sophia, she's holding something in her hand. She's got something in her hand. She's holding a thing. A lantern? No, forget that. That was dumb. She's holding a thing. I'm getting a book or perhaps a pumpkin or a candle holder. Oh, we got a candle holder. Good, great. Now that must be what I was getting. For some reason, I'm also getting a candle. Does that ring any bells? Oh, it does. Okay. I'm getting somebody in the audience who wants a hot dog.
Yeah!
Somebody who's hungry for a hot dog. Ball cloth cream. Anybody? We got Daryl on.
Thanks so much, Daryl. You're a dream.
Could not make it today. Dr. Stockup is a busy man. But we're gonna do it anyway, just see how it works. Just gonna see how it works. You have something to say? What thing?
The thing, you have to thank.
Okay. Okay. Okay, I'd like to introduce the band here. Here over here, we have Eddie the Pirate, John Coleman, Shane on the drums, and Joel Green on the guitar. We're going to commence with the singing here. It's a little song entitled The NNU Blues about all the pain and suffering that all of you go through.
Amen, brother.
Thank you.
Give you a few pointers on how to get that princess, you know, in your life.
Clue you in.
Yeah, for the fellas, they need a little help, but
we can get all the help.
We are the resident experts. So, we'll just start off. The first thing you need to do is be chivalrous. Princes are chivalrous.
Amen. Good advice.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. Say you're walking down the hall. Girl's walking past you. I'm so sorry. Let me get this for you.
What a sweetheart. That was good. Try that with myself. The second one that we find in my limited experience, girls like you to be there for them. Am I right? So say you're trying to woo said girl, or maybe you just have wooed her and started to date. She wants you to be there for her. So here's a girl, and she's just doing her daily routine.
So if you get more exposure time that way, then
right, they like that.
They'll start.
Some people call it stalking. I don't know. Maybe you can
judge
that. Okay.
Okay, the third thing we like to do, you gotta have a sense of humor. Girls like a guy with a sense of humor. You make them laugh, you get to their heart. You know, say you're sitting at the desk. Hey, would you like to sit down?
Okay, hey, let me get this shit through.
Lastly, and I think this is one of the most important things. Girls like it when you listen to them. You need to listen to girls, they appreciate that. Watch. Hi, Jeremy.
Hi, honey.
How was your day?
I just had a really rough day at work. Nobody noticed me. I just...
Really?
I work so hard.
Maybe it's because you're too ugly. Yeah, well, maybe you should try wearing clothes that aren't so unattractive and wear makeup every once in a while.
Do something to help.
Crap, what else is going on? Huh?
Well, man,
I
work... He just keeps being a jerk to me. You know, he'd be nice to him. And...
Well, maybe if you weren't so dislikable, he'd like you better.
So you're saying I should smile more?
Right, and not look so ugly.
You've always been there for me.
That's why I'm here. If you ever need a listening ear, I'm here for you.
Thank you.
You want to go have some hot dogs?
I think now's a great time.
A little bit lately, and notice that you all need some education as well. As we get started, I'd like to introduce you to my assistant. He's been with me for a while. You may remember him. Surprisingly, he stuck around. Jesse, please come on. We also have another addition to our team. I'm going to go ahead and let him introduce himself. Come on out, fellas.
Call me Darkness.
Thank you, Darkness. All right. Let's get started. Our first situation may be familiar to some of you gentlemen. Have you ever got yourself in trouble with what we like to call your mouth? Because I know I have. So, we're going to set up a little situation here. Jesse, get ready. Now, let's just say that you see a girl. You think she's pretty. You want to talk to her. So you do. Let's watch what happens. Safety first! You won't need them. Let's begin our demonstration. Jesse, you're looking very pretty today.
What's that supposed to mean? I look nice every day.
You'll know. That a seemingly innocent comment has become my worst enemy. At this point, you have a couple of options. Method A is to try to talk yourself out of it. Gentlemen, never works. Watch. Start the scene over. Jesse, you look very nice today.
What's that supposed to mean? I look nice every day.
Well, what I meant to say was is that you look nicer today than on the other days, and you look a little bit worse on the other great. You'll notice that I'm about to get struck. Unacceptable. At this point, I will introduce you to something that every man should have on his person at all times. If you do not, you are asking for trouble. Darkness. Woo! Baby powder. Almost as effective as mace. Less slimy. Get a good portion into your hand. Darkness? today.
What's that supposed to mean? I look naked.
Situation. Now for our next situation. Let's say, gentlemen, I know I have this problem at least, when a girl pursues you too much. No, let's set up a situation. You're in the depths. You want some potatoes, French fried, with some ketchup. Now you're waiting in line, and you're waiting, and you're waiting, and she comes up to you. Let's stop the scene.
Hey Nate, can I go to dinner with you tonight?
Freeze frame. You'll notice the bodily contact has been made. Method A, I like to call the gross out method. Watch and learn, ladies and gentlemen, watch and learn. Jesse, start the scene over.
Hey, Nate, can I go to dinner with you tonight?
I would love to, but I have to pick up my prescription cream for the infectious rash I've developed. Effective. However, there is a drawback. Girls like to do what we around here call talk. This girl will go and talk to all of her friends. And here's the outcome. The girls you want, you're not getting. The girls you're getting, you don't want. Darkness. Woo! Jesse, start the scene.
Hey, Nate, can I go to dinner with you today?
That bodily contact was almost made, but not completely. The assailant has been left disillusioned. You may continue with your meal. There are times in a man's life when he will come up against a male assailant. Some of the people at NNU have what we like to call committed relationships. Say that a pretty girl catches your eye. You want to go up and talk to her, but it turns out she has a boyfriend. You talk to her anyway. Watch and see what happens. Jesse, take off the wig.
Hey! That's my
freeze frame! Freeze frame. Start with this method, Duckett. Whoa! second, he's just gonna get mad. Continue the demonstration. Freeze frame! Bodily contact, unacceptable! At this point, we utilize something that I was taught in my self-defense training for when you are attacked. Watch carefully. Jesse, we're gonna do this in slow motion. Stop the scene.
Hey! That's my girl! No, we're not!
Take his girl to dinner, take his girl to a movie, or let her tend to her fallen man. I would suggest the first two, that's just me. This has been your self-defense instruction, gentlemen. Use it sparingly, use it wisely, be safe, and love everybody. Good night!
Rapunzel, let down your
hair. Who are you?
Well, I'm a handsome pimp. I mean, handsome pimp. Well, I just was walking through the woods and I heard you sing and you.
You're walking through the woods?
Well, I didn't have a lot else to do. I have a lot of free time. I'm friends and. Well, anyway, I just heard you singing, and I wanted to see what beautiful lips made such sweet melodies.
Seasons, what do you want with my hair?
I was hoping you could let it down so I could climb up it to you.
What? You daft? A joke in me for you to climb up my hair. Go rip my scalp off.
I was just thinking maybe you could wrap it a couple times around the window hook. And then drop it to me so it's anchored.
Okay.
Thank you.
There.
Wow, your hair is very strong.
Yeah, well, I should hope so. I use Bylaw strength and conditioning.
Good. You do. Well, Rapunzel. You are by far the most beautiful woman I've ever had in my life. I would like to rescue you from here and make you my wife.
What? I don't even know you.
Well, okay, you can dance a little distress, and I'm the handsome friend.
Okay, wait. Alright.
What did you say?
Okay, you're sort of answering it like Troy McGuire. See, I'm going to go for the Heath Ledger turn.
Like you're in a place to pick, you're locked in a tower. You've never even seen another man before. I'm a prince, you're a damsel in distress. I'm come to rescue you from this terrible predicament.
Oh, it's not so bad.
Not so bad.
Oh, yeah, I get HBO and all that.
Okay, Rapunzel, I don't think you understand. Let's go through this again.
Okay.
You're the answer in distress. I'm the Hans Prince. And you live in a tower. I have huge estates, lots of power, money.
Oh, so that's what it's all about, huh? Power and money. Take them in. So like you just want to get me in the back so you can put me on your shelf like a trophy.
You're giving me a chance to puzzle. You notice that I love you. I will never be able to love again if I do not have you as my wife. Please, please, marry me. Wait a minute, you can't even... There's not even a postal route for miles around. You don't even have a mailbox. What are you gonna...
I'm seeing someone.
You're seeing someone?
Yeah, you know...
Because you're locked in the tower.
Right, yeah.
You've never seen anyone before in your life.
Right, yeah. I'm seeing someone. Oh, his name is, Jerry. Jerry! Yeah,
right, Jerry.
Yeah, I met him at the fish market.
Okay, since you've been locked in the tower this whole time.
Hey,
you know, this is just ridiculous. I don't think I can take it, man. I'm just gonna go.
Oh, Prince, I never meant to hurt you. Honestly, it's not you, it's me.
Okay, well, good luck with that.
Yeah, okay, see you. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
I guess I'll just let your hair down.
Okay, that's cool.
So, there were these three couples sitting down having tea.
Mm-hmm.
And one husband says to his lady, he says, hey, that's the honeymoon, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Right, so the next guy says, hey, pass the sugar. Mm-hmm. And the next one says, hey, pass the tea, man!
So what are you reading there today?
Oh, this one? This is my back issue of Elderly Woman's Life magazine.
Oh, what year and what month?
June 1944.
Wait, is that the one with the Freud pinup?
Oh, yes.
Freud.
It's not in there anymore. It's on my wall. Life size. That doctor can heal my ills.
delicious.
Who are you?
Patrick Swayze.
Oh, that's a good one.
Swayze my comes away.
What's the other one, though? You know, besides the celebrities, you know, I mean, any man that I would choose for my husband or mate or...
Is this your list that you've been working on?
Oh, yes. It started in this magazine. Anyway, you know, have to be honest and caring. Rich, dependable, suave, cordial.
Good looking, handsome, yes.
Great muscles, firm colon. But you know what?
I think I know where it's getting at.
Honestly, there's one thing that a man has to have. Yeah. Oh my. Can you attest to this, ladies? A man has to be wearing tights!
You need to have to get on. It's right. You gotta be a man to wear tights. Well, that makes sense. Every time.
Thank you. We have one last act for you. They're coming back from Jack in the Box. I can't afford to jump up.
With us in it.
With us in it.
To make it back in time, it's close.
It's real close. So it's midnight now.
And hope you go back to your cars or pump up as it may be.
As it will be.
And have a great night.
You're a great audience.